Hey guys, what's up? It's Jessiara. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. For today's video, I am going to be doing a university Q&A. Basically all the stuff that I wish I knew before I applied for university, all the stuff that I wish somebody told me. I wish somebody told me this information. My friend Kira. Kira messaged me and she asked for me to do a university Q&A, well, university type video. So that's what this video is going to be all about. I've compiled a bunch of notes on this page for you guys and just giving you guys tips on how to apply for university, how to go through UCAS, how to do your personal statement mainly. But before we start the video, guys, if you don't know who I am, my name is Jessiara Marriott. I'm 18 and I'm from London and I'm studying at Manchester Metropolitan. I am studying fashion, art, direction. Oh, can't get over the name. Yeah, guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new, press the subscribe button. It's down somewhere down there. I just reached 1,000 subscribers, so thank you so much for all of you who are subscribed. If you're not subscribed, I don't really know what to say to you, but yeah, let's just get on with this video, guys. I'm going to start off with my experience, how I found the UCAS application process. Do I want to say what college I went to? No, I studied media, drama and English literature in first year, and then in second year I dropped English literature to do an EPQ, an extended project, that I got a D on in the end, but that's okay. I'm here, I'm in university now, so that's okay. The thing I was most stressed out about was what to put in my personal statement, what they wanted to see, because I was reading all these examples online of like fashion students' personal statements, and it just wasn't a bit of me, do you get what I mean? It was not me, and when I was reading it, I was like, you guys are not, that's not me. So I had to draft and make my tutor read everything. So I just watched a bunch of YouTube videos and that kind of helped me through it. That's why I'm making this video for you guys today. So overall, I struggled in picking a university, and I will tell you guys how I ended up picking Manchester Metropolitan. First thing I'm going to be talking about for you guys is personal statements and just some overall tips, what to put in it, the direct structure that you guys should follow. Now, when I tell you this, the reason why I'm here today, the reason why I'm in my university, the reason why I'm studying at Manchester Metropolitan, the reason why I got accepted into my other places and my first choice, which we're gonna get into, is because of my personal statement. I got comments back from advisors saying that my personal statement was good, that it reached a certain standard, and that because of my extracurricular activities that I did outside of college, that's why I got into the places, that's why I was given, you know, certain conditions, but I'll get into that. So the first two tips, they're kind of combined. The first two tips that I can give you guys before even starting your personal statement, if you've started your personal statement already, which it's around October time, so most of you have, but before you do your final drafts, you need to think about and think, sit in depth, sit down at your desk, sit on your bed, sit with some friends, maybe if you don't want to do it by yourself, sit with your parents, sit with your siblings, and think, what do I want to study and where do I want to study? That is the core when applying to university. Manchester Met was my second choice. I always wanted to go to UAL, University of the Arts in London. I wanted to study at London College of Fashion. That was my dream for like 5 years, until I had a terrible interview. I never expected my interview to be that bad. I never expected the interviewer at that university to be so rude and so disrespectful to me. And I complained and I got an offer because I complained, but we move. I'm here today and I love my course. Think of something that you actually enjoy doing, not something that your friends enjoy doing or what your family wants you to do. I know it's hard, and I know that peer pressure can be a lot, but if I'm going to be studying a subject for 3+ years, if you're a creative person like me, I'm studying fashion. If you're a creative person, you want to study graphic design or something, and you apply for nursing, they don't really correlate now, do they? The man's fashion, but there's lots of niches, there's lots of individual topics within fashion. So there's fashion design, there's fashion styling, there's fashion textiles, there's fashion photography. So think of a course that you actually like, that you actually will enjoy doing, that you want to learn more about, that you want to get a degree in, that you will possibly use when you leave university. The second thing is thinking of a location. Now, when I applied for university, this time last year, I never ever thought, of leaving London. Leaving London wasn't an option for me because I'm such a city girl. I love London. London's my city. I know London like the back of my hand. I know the good places in London, the bad places in London. I have a home in London that I love, and staying in London was ideal for me. I had an idea because I expected myself to get into UAL, and I didn't. And when I didn't get into UAL, everything switched. Everything really did switch for me. Think, do you want to stay at home or do you want to leave home? Personally, for me, the advice that I can give to you guys is to leave home. That's just because it is such an experience. I'm in Manchester, 5-hour drive away from London. I can't just get in a car and go around the corner to London. It's not like that. All of my friends that I have here can just go home and they can just drive their car. Being in Manchester has taught me so much. I've been here for just over a month and it doesn't feel like it. It feels like I've been here for years. It just teaches you, leaving home teaches you how to be an adult, because you leave home at 18, 19, 20, however old you are. But this is for college students, so fresh 18-year-olds like me. Leaving home is the best thing that I could personally advise for you guys, because it teaches you how to be an adult, it teaches you how to be independent, it teaches you how to look after yourself and how to budget and how to cook for yourself and how to make friends and how to be in a professional environment by yourself, so that when you leave university, you're like 22, 23 years old and you're ready to live your adult life properly. I miss having everything there. I had to purchase everything that I have here. And at home, everything's already there for you. So leaving home really does make you appreciate, it's so deep, but leaving home does make you appreciate home, you know? Whilst if you stay at home, like I know some friends in college stayed in London and they stayed at home, they didn't move into halls. That's okay as well. It just depends on your living situation. If you can't afford halls, that's perfectly fine. If you're from a small area, if you're from a small micro town in the middle of nowhere and you want to move to the city, do that as well, because experiencing a different lifestyle is the best thing that can happen to you. In all honesty, guys. On to personal statements and what to include. The first thing is an introduction. A hello, my name is Jessiara Marriott. I am so years old. I'm studying maths, economics, and political sciences. Oh my gosh, I'll never ever study that in my life. Also, when you do your personal statement, it has to be broad to all subjects that you apply for. So for me, when I was applying for fashion, I had a course for fashion styling, I had a course for fashion art direction, styling and production, fashion journalism. I had different types of fashion courses that I was applying for. I had to keep it broad and I had to make sure that my information that I included in my personal statement catered to each of those subjects. So yeah, a brief introduction. Who are you? Tell your story. I loved this bit up until the middle, then I got stressed. But tell them who you are, tell them your name, tell them where you're from, tell them what you want to study, tell them why you want to study it. A little brief background on who you are. Don't elongate it, don't make it 5 paragraphs long. Just keep it a couple sentences long. Keep it short, snappy and simple, straight to the point, and then get onto the main bit that they actually want to read. What you've done outside of college, any extracurricular activities, any work experience, any volunteering, anything you've done outside of college that contributes towards your course that will make you a standout applicant, because that's what Kira asked. Kira asked, Jess, how do you make your personal statement unique? How do you make it cater towards you? That's easy. Each individual has a different story. That's what I believe anyway. Each individual has a different story and they have something different to deliver. I'll be honest with you guys. The biggest thing that got me into these universities, I think, was that I started a magazine at 16 years old. If you guys don't know, I have a fashion magazine, cover magazine. I started at 15, 16, and I produced a first issue and I produced a second issue. The fact that I became an entrepreneur, a businesswoman at the age of 16, and that I done it all by myself. This has taught me business management skills. This has taught me teamwork skills. This has taught me communication skills. This has taught me organization, time management, blah, blah, blah. You just say all those big words, basically. And that will show them that you are ready for university, that you are ready to study the course. Because university isn't them spoon feeding you the information. It's not you don't do the work and they shout at you. It's you don't do the work and they don't care. Honestly, just talk about stuff that you've done outside of college. It can be anything. It can be something weird. It can be something quirky. Just make it personal to you, not to anybody else. Because reading all these examples online really stressed me out. I was like, rah. I didn't go to London Fashion Week. I didn't walk the runway. You know, I didn't do any of that stuff. And that's okay. They don't really care about all the highbrow stuff that you've done. They don't care about all the lowbrow stuff that you've done. They just care they just want to see that you care about the course and that you want to be in the course, that you actually want to be there, not that, you know, you're BSing your way.
Yeah, so after the extracurricular stuff, after all the academic stuff that you've done, then talk about hobbies. What stuff do you like to do outside of college?
It doesn't have to be academic related at all. Like for me, I said I danced for 5-6 years. Saying the weird stuff that you're into, like if you like chess, say you like chess. If you like hockey, say you like hockey. If you like deep dive swimming in the Atlantic Ocean, say you like doing that. It doesn't have to be academic related at all. They just want to see that you have hobbies outside of college. If you don't have any hobbies, if all you do is sit in your bed and watch Netflix until 3 in the morning, you know, you can say you do that because you're honest.
If you're doing something academic, i.e. English, literature, business, law, anything to do with that, talk about a book that you're currently reading. That is one thing that I can heavily suggest. A lot of my friends that are studying now, like journalism, for example, that's what I wanted to study originally. All my friends that are studying journalism, they talked about a book or a documentary or just something that they're listening to or reading at the moment. And don't say something general like John Green, Fault in Our Stars. Don't. Talk about, I don't know, an academic book that you're reading that you are excited to use as extra reading in your course, because that will get them excited. You know, they'll be like, yay. And the last bit that you guys should add is what skills that you have. What skills do you think that you have that could contribute towards the course? Like me, I said, I think I'm a natural born leader. That's what I talked about in my final paragraph. I also said that I think I have great team building skills. I said I have great communication skills. I am one of the biggest extroverts you will ever meet. I never used to be an extrovert, ever, ever. I hated people. I hated talking to people, period. When I left secondary school, moving into college, I was so chatty, I was so talky. I just love people. I'm a people person. I love being around people. I love being around different groups of people. Hence moving to Manchester. I love it. I love it because there's so many different personalities here. Okay, so that's the structure of a personal statement that I would do. That I'd done, and that most of my friends done as well. That's the structure that my tutors told me. That's the structure that people don't really talk about. Everyone always talks about some structure that's very robotic and it's not fluid at all. It's just very, you have to say this, 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 and this, and this, and then you get in. When that's not the case, they want to see that you have personality. They don't want to see that you're a carbon copy of somebody else. They can tell that your personal statement has been replicated, or you've copied it but changed a couple words. They can tell. So you just make it you, because the personal statement encapsulates who you are. They are not going to put a face to your personal statement. They don't know who you are. So essentially you just have to give them your best self and hope for the best, basically. Okay guys, so that was a personal statement. Just some quick key tips that I can give to you guys that I really want you to take away before I conclude this video, before I forget. I wrote it all down. What your friends pick doesn't matter.
I moved to Manchester with zero friends, zero family, zero acquaintances. I knew nobody moving to Manchester. Obviously, before I moved, I contacted people in my course. I contacted people who live in my flat. I contacted people who live in my accommodation. That's about it. But I don't know these people. I didn't bring them from London to Manchester. And coming here, I found people who are from the same kind of area as me in London. And we bonded on just the area and leaving and how great it was to leave. What your friends pick in terms of course and university, it genuinely doesn't matter, because if they are your friends, they won't be like, Jessiara, why are you not picking criminology? Because you don't flipping want to do criminology. Jessiara, why are you not picking maths? Because I like English. What the, like, it generally doesn't matter. If they were your friends, they were like whatever course that you picked. My best friend from back home, Eleanor, miss and love you so much, but she's studying media at university and she's back in London. She's living at home and we're in two different places, but I still talk to her every single day. She doesn't hate me for moving to Manchester. There's a bunch of people that think moving to Manchester for me was a terrible choice, and there's a bunch of people who love it and who are watching my videos and seeing me do well, and who are seeing me make mistakes, and who are seeing me grow up, basically. So wherever you decide to go, make sure you have a great time there. University is a lonely place. I know everybody says that, darling, it's true. University is lonely. It's a lonely place because after a while you're just in your own devices. You're not going out every single day like I was in freshers. I'm not going out every single day.
I'm in my accommodation room with a phone in front of me filming a video. You guys have to learn how to be okay by yourself. I know it's hard if you're moving away from home, it's definitely hard, but you will stay in contact with friends and family, and that's definitely okay. I wish I told myself to slow down during college. Second year of college was one of the best, but also one of the messiest years in my life, because a lot happened, especially media. I had to learn a year's worth of topics from first year condensed into 2 months in second year. It was intense. I was stressed. I was crying. I wasn't sleeping. I wasn't eating. I was stressed. I was stressed, and I walked out with a B in media. So thank God. Slow down, enjoy your youth, have fun living at home, have fun not being able to pay for everything, because you will miss it. Okay, you will miss it. I'm telling you that now. You will miss it. And if you are financially smart, if you're financially stable, if you've got friends and family that can help you out, that's great. Make sure you focus on your A-levels. Don't stress yourself out to the point where you're not eating or sleeping or doing any of that, please. Your mental health comes first. I don't care what no one tells you. I don't care what no one tells me. Your mental health, your well-being, how you are performing in your academics come first. It doesn't matter if you've got the biggest exam of your life the next day and you haven't eaten, you haven't slept. Go to sleep, stop revising. If you don't feed yourself, if you don't get enough sleep, you will not be able to perform at your best. That comes with anything. Anything, darlings. When I didn't sleep, when I didn't eat, and I had an exam the next day, oh my gosh, I was struggling, and I took shots of espresso every single day for my exams. That killed me. That killed me. And I'm still recovering from it. I'm still recovering from it, she says with a coffee machine in her room. When it comes to the exam period of April, June, July, whenever that is, I'm telling you, you will have the best summer of your life once your exams are over. You don't have to think about anything. You don't have to revise for anything when you go to university. I had a fun summer just chilling and filming and going to picnics and going to fun fairs. It was fun. I had a fun summer. So just take time, chill, and enjoy it. Study, yes. Work hard, yes. But also make sure you take time out to focus on your mental health. Focus on how you are up here. Because if you're not good up here, you're not going to be good out here. Okay? Okay. Close my notebook, put it down. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really, really, really hope this video helped some of you, if not all of you, helped at least one of you. I'm going to send this video to Kira as well, because that's why I made the video for Kira. This is valuable information that I wish somebody told me. I wish someone sat in front of me and said, Jessiara, here's what you need to do. Do it now. And if you guys follow the structure that I talk about in my book, if you guys follow the structure that I have, I will list it, shall I list it in descriptions, I'll list it in the comments for you guys, and I'll pin the comment for you guys. Okay, look at me, I'm your big sis helping you out. Right? Okay, right, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you really liked it, give it a thumbs up and share this video with some of your friends, if you, because you all sit down and watch this together. All right, sit down and watch this together, get your ish together. Also, oh my god, go to open days. You say you want to study in Manchester and you haven't even visited Manchester yet. Oh, you're ridiculous. You say you want to go to Ireland and study in Belfast and you haven't even been to Belfast. Stop it. Go to open days as well, guys. And if you're not subscribed, you might as well. You're already here and you made it to the end of the video, so well done. Subscribe. Thank you so much. Help me get to 1.1k. Might as well. You might as well just... We're just stepping up from now on, guys. All right. Check out my university series from episode 1 to episode 8. I believe this is, and don't forget to follow me on all my socials. Everything will be in the description box, and don't forget to stay happy, stay safe, and stay inspired, and I'll check you guys out in my next video. Bye bye.